Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial designing an impressive architectural building in AutoCAD 2018 interior. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_017_DIAB where you save it. You can also go and download this file from the website. If you don't have access to the exercise file, you can use your own file to follow along. Now, if you look at the first floor plan, we need to create a window in this area. So we're going to use a different technique to create this window. Go to the Home tab and Solid Edit panel, click this down arrow and select Copy Edge. AutoCAD asks you to select an edge. To make the task easier for us, go to the selection panel and click this down arrow and turn the edge filter on. Now, hover your mouse cursor into this corner and select the edge and press enter. Then, AutoCAD asks you to specify a base point of displacement. Click into this area and move your mouse cursor until you see the midpoint object snap, but don't click. Now type 2 feet on your keyboard and press enter. AutoCAD copy the edge into a new location. At the prompt, enter an edge editing option. Move your mouse cursor and select the copy option, or go to the status bar and click the copy option. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit a little bit, then select this edge and press enter. At the prompt specifying base point of displacement, click into this area. Now move your mouse cursor and hover it on top of the edge that you just copied, but don't click. Type 2 feet on your keyboard and press enter. At the prompt, enter an edge editing option, copy, color, undo, exit prompt. Move and select the copy option. Select this edge and press enter. At the prompt specifying base point of displacement, click on this edge and move your mouse cursor down. Now type 3 feet on your keyboard and press enter. So press escape to get out of the solid edit command. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the copy command. AutoCAD asks you to select object. Go to the selection panel and turn on the selection filter to no filter. Now click above the wall, then use a crossing window selection. When you do, you select both the line and the 3D wall. Now hold down your shift key and deselect the wall. Press enter. At the specifying base point prompt, hold down your shift key and right click if your intersection object snap is not running. Now at the specifying second point or displacement prompt, move your mouse cursor and hover it on this area. Now type 4 feet on your keyboard and press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. As you can see, during the copy process, you select more than you want. So go and select this line if you have the same situation and click the delete key to erase it. Go to the Home tab, Modeling panel, and click the Press Pull command. Click inside this closed boundary to press it out. Press it more than the thickness of the wall. You can click anywhere you want or type in a figure. For example, if I type 7 inches and press enter, AutoCAD creates a hole because the 7 inches is thicker than the wall. As you can see, AutoCAD doing the calculation in the background. If you have a faster system than mine, the press pull command may be completed by now. Now, let's create another window into this area. To do that, we use the box command. Go to the Home tab, Model panel, and select the box format. AutoCAD asks us to specify a plan. We want to use this face as the plan. So to do that, let's turn on the dynamic UCS on. When you turn the dynamic UCS, anywhere you have your mouse cursor, that face become the current X and Y plane. As you can see, when you have the mouse cursor in any face, the face is highlighted. Now click on this area and move your mouse cursor and click here. Again, if you don't see your dynamic UCS on the status bar, click this button and place a check mark to the dynamic UCS. Now move the mouse cursor until it cross this wall and click. Go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and select the subtract command. Select this wall, press enter, and select the box that you just placed and press enter. AutoCAD subtract the box from this wall. Now go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the freeze layer button. Select this wall to freeze it. Press escape. Select these temporal lines and erase them. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the previous layer button. When you click this button, AutoCAD will turn into the pre-status of the layer. Now let's unite the beams and the main model. Go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and click the union command. Select this wall, the beam, this beam, this beam, this beam, and press enter. AutoCAD converts them into one object. Press enter again to repeat the union command. Select this wall, this beam, this beam, this, 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 and press enter. AutoCAD convert them into one wall. Now select this model, and click the delete key to verify. You see the model are now one wall. To bring back the object, whenever you use the delete command, you can bring it back by using the oops command. The oops command brings the most recent erased object. Type on your keyboard oops and press enter. AutoCAD brings back the object. Alright, in this tutorial, we'll learn how to use the copy edge command to create a window. We'll also use the box command to create a box and subtract it to a 3D wall to create an opening for the window. In the next tutorial, we'll start to create our slab. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like and share it to your friend. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue on this series or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.